So now, in this question, you are asked to prove that p of n plus 1 plus p of p plus 1 whole power 2 n minus 1 is always divisible by p square plus p plus 1 for all natural numbers. So, using principle of mathematical induction, let us try to prove this. So, now, first step is verification step. So, put n is equal to 1. So, for n is equal to 1, you get p square plus p plus 1 whole power 1, which is equal to p square plus p plus 1, which is divisible by p square plus p plus 1. Hence, the statement is true for n is equal to 1. There is no doubt about it. And next, let us go to assumption step. So, let us assume that p of m plus 1 plus p plus 1 whole power 2m minus 1 is divisible by p square plus p plus 1 is divisible by p square plus p plus 1. That is, let us assume that in mathematical language, this is equal to p square plus p plus 1 times some function of p. That is, if you divide this with this, you won't have any remainder, you just have a quotient, polynomial. So, here I cannot take it as a number because this is a polynomial divided by polynomial gives a polynomial as a quotient. So, p power m plus 1 plus p plus 1 whole power 2m minus 1, let it be equal to this into this. Now, so let us go to p of m plus 1. That is, so you have to prove that p of n, in the place of n you have to put n plus 1. So, p of m plus 2 plus p plus 1 whole power 2 times m plus 1 minus 1 is 2m plus 1 is divisible by p square plus p plus 1. So, you have to prove that this is divisible by p square plus p plus 1. So, our assumption is this is divisible by this. You have to conclude that this is divisible by. So, we have to prove that this expression is divisible by p square plus p plus 1 using this assumption. Now, let us consider this. P power m plus 2 plus p plus 1 power 2m plus 1 is equal to. So, p power m plus 2 can be written as p times p power m plus 1 plus p plus 1 whole power 2m plus 1. So, p power m plus 1 from the assumption can be written as p times p square plus p plus 1 times f of p minus of p plus 1 whole power 2m minus 1 plus p plus 1 whole power 2m plus 1. So, p power m plus 1 has been written as this minus this. So, now this is equal to p square plus p plus 1 times f of p is again another function of p minus p times p plus 1 whole power 2m minus 1 plus p plus 1 whole power 2m plus 1. So, this can be written as, so this is divisible by p square plus p plus 1. So, p square plus p plus 1 times some function of p minus of, so from these two, if you take p plus 1 whole power 2m minus 1 as common, so you get p minus of p plus 1 whole square. So, that is equal to p square plus p plus 1 times f dash of p minus p plus 1 whole power 2m minus 1 times p minus of p plus 1 whole square is p square plus 2p plus 1. So, what happens if you subtract this? You get minus p square minus p minus 1. So, can you see that you have a p square plus p plus 1 here also? If we take this minus outside, so you have a p square plus p plus 1 here and you also have a p square plus p plus 1 here. So, that is equal to p square plus p plus 1 times, so whatever is remaining, f dash of p minus into minus becomes plus p plus 1 whole power 2m minus 1. So, this whole thing can be considered as another function. So, you have p square plus p plus 1 as a factor of this. Hence, p power m plus 2 plus p plus 1 whole power 2m plus 1 is divisible by p square plus p plus 1. Hence, so we have completed the proof step. Hence, by principle of mathematical induction, the conclusion step, by PMI, by principle of mathematical induction, P of n is true for all n belongs to natural numbers. P of n is true for all n belongs to natural numbers.